Some exciting news, guys. We have an intern here at the Cinecom Studios. He'll be staying with us for several months. His name is Lorenzo. Here he is. Hi, Lorenzo.
Hi.
He's going to film this episode as well, so I'm going to hand over the camera to him. Much better. Got my hands free now. I can do everything now.
Jordy, catch.
Yeah! Catch, Janik. It's Jordy here for Cinecom.net, and welcome to again a super exciting episode of Copycat. Now, this is a weekly series where we recreate a cool effect and show you guys how it's done. But today, we were inspired by Taylor Swift's music video Style. Now, you can see several shots in there where two clips are brought together. And this technique is called double exposure and is actually quite popular among photographers. The music video was published on YouTube in 2015, but it is still a very popular effect. You can see it as well in the intro of True Detective. The double exposure effect is not just something that we can solely do in Premiere Pro. We need to pay attention to our lighting in the shots. We have a huge surprise for you guys. We actually arranged the real Taylor Swift today for this tutorial video. Check it out, guys. There she is, Taylor Swift. Only her legs are a little bit shorter than the real Taylor, but for the rest, it's all exactly the same.
Look what you made me do.
The idea is that you create a lot of contrast in your shot. You want to have a very white background and a dark subject in the front. You can also swap that because in Premiere Pro we can say reverse the mask blending thing. So anyways, it's kind of the same principle as setting up a green screen. Here you also want to have an even lighting over the white background. And then for the second zone up in the front, you want to have a separate lighting for your subject, which is going to be more of a dark lighting. So everything that is black or dark on a shot can be blended with a second clip inside Premiere Pro. So that means if you wouldn't place any light onto Kim, her entire body could be filled up with that second clip. Now the reason why we are adding some reflection, some extra highlights onto Kim is to make certain parts come visible through the second clip. So for example, her face, so that only her back, which is actually dark or black, has that second clip in it. But her face, which is getting that highlight, will come through. So that is something that you can play with. You can add certain highlights onto your dark subject, knowing that those highlights will come through your blended clip. So you can do this in a studio environment like we did, but you can also go outside and shoot against a bright sky. You can also go with buildings or other objects during a sunset. And the clips that you are seeing right now here are all coming from Storyblocks. It's a library where you can download such stock clips from, but also other video effects, templates, title animations, and much more. Now, they are one of the main sponsors here on the channel, which we are very grateful for, but we are also a very heavy user of their library ourselves. I can definitely recommend it to anyone. Storyblocks even gives everyone the chance to try it out for 7 days. You can follow the first link in the description below to find out more. Janik took a day off yesterday because it was Valentine's Day. Isn't that right, little turtle dove? Now we've taken several shots, let's bring them now inside Premiere Pro. And here is one of the clips that we've shot. As you can see, there's a plain white background and Kim is a silhouette. We'll place this clip onto video track number 1. Then find yourself a shot that you want to blend with your subject. And this could be a video or a photo. We did find out that it works best on clips that were shot on a tripod. Here I have some trees, which I'll place in the second video track. And now it's just a simple matter of selecting that second clip, heading over to the effects controls, and under opacity, choose the lighten blend mode. And that's it. Now some clips might not give you the right results, and that is because of the contrast and exposure. So select your subject clip and then go through the Lumetri color panel. And here you can decrease the shadows or blacks a bit to reveal the blended clip in there. You can also adjust your exposure in general. Now where you don't want the clip to appear through your shot, you have to make it brighter. You can also take more control of where your blending has to take place by creating a mask on that layer. Simply select your forest shot and under the opacity property click on the pen tool to draw a mask. Now make sure to feather that mask afterwards so that the edges won't come visible. In the music video you can also see that the blended clips follow Taylor's movement. And this is probably done with some 3D tracking and some more complex techniques. But we have found a way to mimic that through some simple effects in Premiere Pro. In your effects library, search for the basic 3D, then drag that effect to the forest clip. And this allows you to swivel the clip. So create a keyframe for that property and animate it so that it follows the turn of your subject. You can also animate the position or the scale property if needed. And when done right, it should look something like this. As a final touch, I'm going to add the turbulent displace effect to the clip. You may set the displacement to bulge, and then the size to 10. Then I would animate the amount going from 0 to around 50, and then back to 0. For an overall movement of the effect, you need to animate the evolution from 0 to around 50 degrees. Now, as you can see, this will give some texture to the forest clip, making it seem more like it's part of Kim's body, kind of a glass effect. On her back, it definitely looks good, but around her head, not so much. To fix that, you can click on the pen tool under the turbulent displace effect, and then draw an area of where you want that effect to be shown. And that's how to make your double exposure effect a little more advanced. Now, this technique is also pretty cool with a smoke plume. We got one from Videoblocks that we blended over Kim's head. It came out great and was also inspired from the Taylor Swift's music video. To check out more copycat tutorials, you can click any card up there or find a link in the description below. Thank you all so much for watching, and like always, stay creative.
Hey guys, I just recently bought a brand new skateboard. Look at this, it's a girl's bathroom. Now let's go skate.
I don't think it's gonna end well.